Kalpana and you, Vikas, are listening to music. Okay, so you have listened to what I was reading. You have just seen the slide also. Let's see who are taking part in the dialogue. So who are the two persons they are taking part in the dialogue? Yes, one is Kalpana, the other one is Vikas. Can you tell me what are they doing? Now let us see what is mother doing. You have to recall the dialogue, or if you want, again I'll just play the slide. Yeah. See dialogue of Vikas. Vikas is explaining what are the people doing in the house. Next is father. You have father, grandfather, Kiran, and even Vikas. Let's see what activities are going on. What is mother doing? What is father doing? What is grandfather doing? What is Kiran doing? And what is Vikas doing? I hope you have got the answers. Let's check our answers. So do you think, before that, do you think the dialogue is about activities that are being done? Second question, do the activities take place at the time of speaking? Whether yes or no, you have to answer to yourself. Okay, look at the dialogues again. Some of the words are underlined. Do you know why are they underlined? Of course, you are smart enough now, you have already revised why are they underlined, you all know it. So let's see which are the words. Is reading. Is walking, is watching, is studying, am listening. I am listening. Yes, they are, as you have guessed properly, correctly, they are verbs, and verbs, you know, they show or they tell about the current activities and events. All these verbs, all these words, underlined words, they were speaking about the current events or activities going on in Kalpana's or Vikas' house. So one more, you can say how to form present continuous tense. We had revised how to form simple present tense. It's in the same way, let's see how to form present continuous tense. So I, first person pronoun, we, first person pronoun, you, second person pronoun, he, third person pronoun, they, third person pronoun. If you see here, I use are smiling. Smiling, if you know, is the main verb. And before that, am, are, is, are the be forms. If you remember, be, what is be? Be is primary auxiliary verb. What is auxiliary verb? Verb which helps the main verb to speak about the moods or tenses. So here you have, I am smiling. We are smiling. You are smiling, he is smiling, they are smiling. So what is the technique? We form the present continuous tense with the present tense of be. Present tense of be, am, are, is, are. And the ing, if you see, smile is the main verb, and to smile they have added ing. ing form of the main verb. If you see the other sentences which we have done previously in the dialogue, is watching. Watch is the main verb. For that, ing is watching. Is studying, ing. Am listening, ing. Listen, listening. Study, studying. Watch, watching. Meaning of the present tense and when are they used? Okay, so Bindu is working in the garden now. The activity is going on, still going on now, right? We are watching cricket at the moment. At the moment, still we are watching cricket. So it tells about the present continuous tense. The tense or the action is still going on. To talk about something happening now. Words that show present time, which are those words? Now, at the moment, at present, currently, and many other words we use to show that yes, the action is going on now. It's continuing. The temporary or permanent, whether we use it for temporary basis or permanent basis. The rich woman is living in a small house in the village. It depends on the sentence, it depends on the situation. To describe a temporary situation. Why? Because it's only temporary. Her doctor has advised her rest for a month away from the city. Because rich woman, she's actually staying in the city, but she was advised by the doctor, so she has come here only for a temporary basis, for a temporary moment. Study the following sentences. What are you doing this weekend? I am meeting Peter tomorrow. We are driving to Albany this weekend. If you see, they are not future tense. They are telling about planned future events. Planned future events. Here, the tense is present continuous tense only, which speaks about planned future events. Too often or every time. My aunt is always quarreling with her neighbors. If you see, it shows an emotion. What is the emotion? Irritation. Always means too often. My aunt is always quarreling with her neighbors. We'll see a few more sentences because always we place always into two. Why? What is always? Always is adverb. So when you place always, you look over here now. Note with the present continuous tense, when you're using always, she is always complaining about the food. I've taken over here correct because this is the correct form of present continuous tense. Second, she always is complaining about the food. Actually, what is the rule? Always comes between be. What is be form here? Is. And the main verb complaining. Complain. To complain. Complaining is the verb. Here, between this is and complaining, we have this always adverb. So here, always comes between be and the main verb. And second sentence, if you see, immediately after pronoun, they have used adverb over here. So this is not a present continuous tense. The first one is the present continuous tense. Verb can show an action or state. This we had done in the second video when we were learning about verb and verb forms. I had given you what is a verb. And verb, you all know it, is a word which shows an action or state. Now, what is the difference between this? State or stative verbs express a state. These verbs often point out emotions, relationships, the senses or thoughts. The most common state verbs are be and have. If you see, be and have are primary auxiliary verbs. Next is action. Action verbs refer to an action. Example, write, work, break, drink, kick, cook, etc. So, state verbs are not in the continuous. When we are using present continuous tense, if you see, we have learned the present form of be, that is, are, am, and then the main verb we are using, for the main verb we are using ing. So, in the statement, when it states, we don't use ing in the main verb. Example, look here. Nobody knows exactly how the machine works. Here, if you see, knows is the verb. Nobody is knowing exactly how the machine works. As per the rule, for the present continuous tense, we have the present form of be over here, is, and know is the main verb. They have used ing. But if you see, this sentence is wrong. It is not a present continuous tense. It's not a proper form because state verbs are not in the continuous. This tonic contains 5% alcohol. It's correct because contains is the verb. Here you see, this tonic is containing 5% alcohol. It's a wrong statement, a wrong sentence. Many times it happens that same verb, it states state or it states action also. Okay? A verb can sometimes have two meanings. One showing a state and other an action. I have few examples over here. We just go through examples. I think. If you see, it's a state. I think you are good. Here, think is what? Believing. I believe you are good. But same thing with ing, I am thinking of considering, or because I am thinking of a holiday, means what? I am considering. Same, think is the verb used over here. Same thing is also used over here with ing, but you have, this is the present continuous tense and it shows action. The first one shows state. Okay, they have, here have shows possession, state, several houses in the city. They are having is what? They are organized. Action, a party tonight, ing. The film star comes from Ceylon, means what? Was born, state. If you see comes, they are not coming, it's not come, yeah, they have used comes, it's a state, it's showing a state. She is coming, see comes, same verb in the ing form, coming from Chennai after a shooting, it shows action. A small activity, such type of activities you will be getting in first QC. The phone rings, Sushila answers the call. Sushila, hello. Oh, Kirti, what's up? Kirti, hi Sushi, what are you doing? Sushila, I dash for a test. Of course, we have answers in the last, in the brackets. Kirti, what are Neeta and Namin doing? The same type of exercise will be given to you in first few. It's very, very easy. You can score full marks. So let's see what is the question or what are the options given in the brackets. Is playing and studying, are talking, is stitching, are watching. I dash for a test. I will not tell the answer, you have to guess the answer. Next is, Sushila, they dash TV. You know how crazy they are about Antakshari. It's very, very easy. As I told you, grammar is like math. If you know the rule, you can score full marks. Kirti, yes, I do. Are your parents at home? Sushila, yes, they dash to each other while. What are they doing to each other? He's playing, I'm studying, are talking, he's stitching, are watching. Yes, they dash to each other while my mother dash a new shirt for Varun. The last one, he dash in the garden. It's very, very easy. Now let's see the answers. I hope you've got the right answer. If it is right, out marks. Am studying, I am studying for the test. Are watching, I think Neeta and one more girl, right? They are watching TV. Are talking, who are talking? Mother and father are talking. Mother is teaching and something, what was the last sentence? Yeah, he is playing in the garden. So this was regarding present continuous tense. With this, we finish the revision of simple present tense and present continuous tense. See you next, my next English bridge course. Thank you very much. Have a good day.